Grace to you and peace from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. It all began with a grumble. And the grumble became louder and louder and louder. And the people of God continued to grumble. And they continued to complain against their God and against Moses. What have you brought us out here in the wilderness to do to us? That we would die from hunger? That we would starve to death? Began with a grumble. We had it better off in Egypt. Well, there we had meat to eat, and we had cucumbers. Yeah, and you had captivity, and you had slavery too, yet they grumbled against God, the same God who saved them, who brought them out of that captivity under Pharaoh's hand, who brought them and was leading them back to his promised land. Yet they grumbled, they complained. What are you doing to us, God? And your servant Moses, have you brought us here simply to suffer and to die? And God heard their grumble. And God heard their complaint. And he did not grumble back. He did not complain back. Yet he heard their cries. And he answered. Isn't that our God? Even when we cry out in a grumble, even when we cry out in complaint, he hears and he answers and he provides. And for them he provides, and for you he provides. And so he says to them, that which we too pray for, give us this day our daily bread. And so God hears their grumble, and God hears their complaint, and he is the God who he is, and he does something about it, and he answers that complaint, and he answers that grumble, and he answers that rebellious nature by sending daily bread, quail to satisfy their need, and something else, an odd substance, never seen before. The Bible says that it was like coriander seed, that it was fine, that it was like honey mixed with a wafer. And the people of Israel had an obvious response to it. Mana! What is it? Manna. And yet God, by that manna, and yet God, by that quail, provided for their daily bread, answered their grumble with sustenance. But if you go back and read the account in Exodus, your eyes, as they trail along the story of God's deliverance, will see that God also sends this manna and this quail to test them. Will the people of God really listen to the instructions that he has given? Because when God gives the sustenance to the people, it is just for that day. The manna is for that day. But what will they do? Will they listen to God? And will they enjoy the gift that he gives for that day and that day alone? Or will they try to gather up an abundance that will get them through the next day and the day after. And we know what they do. And we see that they fail God's test. And then we quickly realize that we are all in the same boat. We fail God's test daily. We fall short of His glory daily. As Martin Luther said, we daily sin much. God says, I am providing you with this, and it will be good for you this day. It will keep you alive this day. It will support and it will nourish you for this day, but not for tomorrow, because my goodness and my mercy will be there for you then too. But the people of Israel and you and I are so quick to wonder. God has always kept every promise He's ever given you, yet we wonder. Maybe I should just hold back a little bit more, because maybe there's just an off chance that God won't show up tomorrow. Or if He shows up tomorrow, maybe He won't show up the next day. And we, like the people of Israel, are caught in the midst of our doubt and our wonder and our anxiety and our worry. Yet God said, but what if He doesn't? What if He doesn't come? What if He doesn't provide as He has promised? Well, then I'll be stuck. Oh my. Yet even in the midst of their failure, even in the midst of our own, God provides. He certainly provides, and He kept His people, Israel, nourished and gave them their daily bread. And then Jesus says, your fathers ate the manna in the wilderness, and they died. They did. God provided for them their needs, for their body, for those days that they were wandering around in the wilderness. But the manna and the quail were not their savior. But God certainly does provide, because now as all scripture is opened up to your eyes, you see, you, my friends in Jesus Christ, have the beautiful privilege of seeing that it wasn't just about the manna at all. It wasn't just about people wandering around in the wilderness, but it's about you and them. And about what God would do as He's promised for them. This manna, this bread from heaven, is pointing to the true bread from heaven, Jesus Christ, who provides for every need that you have for both body and soul. Your fathers ate the manna in the wilderness and they died, but I am the bread from heaven, and whoever eats of my flesh and drinks of my blood will never die. Do you see how Jesus repeats that over and over and over here in the gospel? That the gift He gives will endure to everlasting life. He is the true bread come down from heaven, and He does provide for you in every need. And even when you and even when I daily sin much, He comes into those days of your life and He provides, and He provides, and He provides for your needs today, your needs tomorrow, and your needs for forever. Because your greatest need is not that which fills the belly and satisfies the body, but your greatest need is the deliverance from sin, death, and the power of the devil, and He's done it for you. He has come in and He has provided and He has delivered and He has rescued and He has redeemed you. He has bought you back and He fills you daily with His sustenance. Each and every morning as you arise in His name, because you are bought with a price. And you are sealed by God. Each one of you bear the signature of God on your body and on your life. And as you wake up in His name, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And you know that that day He will keep His promise to you to be with you, not to forsake you, not to leave you. And His signature on you will be there throughout your days. Your good days. Your bad days. Your in-between days, He will continue to provide, He will continue to sustain, He will continue to forgive, He will continue to give you life. Jesus said, in this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. The world says to you, you may not get by. Your own flesh to you says, I might not make it. Your own body wants you to doubt, and Jesus comes into your life daily and richly and fills you with His word and His gift and says, I am greater than the world. I am greater than your own flesh. I am greater than your own worries, your own doubts, your own turmoils, and that which I provide for you. I provide for you today and for forevermore. So my brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, it is in these words, these confident and bold and true and powerful words of Jesus Christ that we today gather and rest. Knowing that our Lord, the bread of life, the true bread from heaven, keeps His promise to you and will continue to fill you richly with His gift, even as He does today. He will continue each and every day to forgive you all of your sins and to give you life and salvation. You